Hey guys, welcome back to Clubhouse Kids. So today's video, I want to give you 10 things that I do that help with provider burnout. And so I have been doing my home daycare for a little less than 12 years. And throughout the 12 years, I have definitely hit periods of provider burnout where I've really questioned, do I want to continue my daycare? Especially with having 5 kids of my own, it can be very challenging sometimes. But I do always go back to that I do love what I do. It is a career that I have chosen and something that I do enjoy. So I've come up with 10 things that help me with provider burnout and then also will hopefully help you guys. So if you're interested in that, stick around. The 10 things that I've come up with, there's not any rhyme or reason like to these. There's not like the first one's the most important, the 10th one is the least important. They're just 10 things that I've just kind of jotted down. So the first one would be to keep up on paperwork. And this is especially if you are a licensed provider. It can be very draining if you throughout the month don't do any of your paperwork, and then at the end of the month you're just like have this stack of stuff to do. Paperwork for me is definitely one of the areas that I don't like about having a daycare. I love the planning the activities, spending my days with the kids. The licensing side of stuff is definitely like my least favorite part. So I really work hard on keeping up on my paperwork, keeping up on, you know, filing my receipts in time. And so I don't ever have just this humongous pile of stuff to go through because that can really burn me out very quickly. And so one of the things that I do is that on Thursday evenings, I like to just kind of set an alarm for about 45 minutes and I sit down and I just kind of plow through what I can, paperwork wise, daycare wise, especially even, and then if I have a lot of like receipts or even licensing paperwork to work on, then that's the time that I will start, you know, our monthly calendar, our newsletter, stuff like that, just to kind of keep up on that so it doesn't become overwhelming. Okay, so my second one would be to find other providers in your area. This can be hard to do, especially with home daycares. But there are Facebook groups that you can find with other providers. I actually have am part of a Facebook group for like our food program, and like, and just seeing what other people are having for lunch kind of helped me like, oh, that sounds like a really good idea. And then when I go to do my menus, I will actually jump on that page and look at stuff, and just seeing them post things throughout the day, especially other providers, like, hey, we're doing this, can just be really helpful and make you feel like you're not the only one out there just with a bunch of kids all day. And YouTube, like, this channel has been amazing for that. Like, I've loved meeting other daycare providers and talking with them. And it's just, I think just knowing other providers, interacting with other providers. If you have providers in your area, go to dinner once a month with them, you know, and even you can talk about your daycares, you cannot talk about your daycare. It's helping you to kind of form a circle of other people that are in the daycare field. My third tip is to, if you have set up a program and it's not working, change it. Like, don't feel like you have to stick to the same schedule or the same program that you have set up for, like, especially me, like during the summer, I really kind of prep my year. But if it's not working, change it. If your room layout's not working, change it. Like, don't like struggle through a school year or a year waiting for the time when you would, you know, actually sit down and think about your program for the following year. Like, if it's not working, change it then, because nothing can burn you out faster than a schedule or program you're doing with your kids, a curriculum you're doing with your kids that's just not working. Nobody's enjoying it. So that's my next tip, is to change your program to fit the needs of your kids that you have currently in your program. Okay, for my fourth tip is to set goals for each of your daycare kids. So especially with my infants and toddlers, you know, I will look at their age and I will think to myself as I'm making their lesson plans, like, okay, my goal for, you know, her is dot, dot, dot. My goal for him by the end of the month is dot, dot, dot. And this can help you kind of just keep your focus of what you're working on. This can also give you a goal, like when that child meets that goal, it's just satisfying. And you know, this is something that they did not have 2 weeks ago when you set that goal for them. And it just reminds you of, you know, the love of teaching that I have and just the just like the how kids are just a sponge and just how they're learning every day, and it just gets me excited. So I think that is a great thing to do in your daycare, is to set individual goals for each of your kids. Okay, my fifth tip is to know your hardest time in your day and don't schedule anything that doesn't need to get done during that time. So I'm going to give you an example. My hardest time of the day is about a half an hour before lunch, going through about a half an hour after lunch. It becomes our craziest time. You know, we're trying to finish up, you know, like our crafts at that time. My homeschool kids are wrapping up their morning activities. I need to get lunch started. If it's nice outside, I'm trying to get the kids outside. It can just be a crazy time. So when you're setting your schedule, don't also include like music time during that time, or an additional center time or something like that. So for that whole almost hour and a half, the only thing that needs to get done is lunch. And don't have your expectations so high. So sometimes when I first started daycare, you know, I just tried to squeeze so much into the day. And, you know, with little kids, it was overwhelming. It was overwhelming for me. And so if you have to block out a whole hour and a half for lunch, that's okay. And that's what I do now. And the only thing that needs to get done during that time is lunch. And so if I want to pop a movie in so the kids can sit there and I can get lunch, and then I have that whole time of cleanup. If it's nice out, you know, they can go outside. So my sixth tip is to stick to your policies. And, you know, if you're another provider that have written my your own handbook, you know, you have spent time on that. When I first wrote my handbook, like, I spent a ridiculous amount of time thinking through my daycare, writing out my daycare. Every year I read through my handbook again, I revamp it for new policies, things that I've thought of that didn't work in the past. And so you just spend a lot of time on those policies. So respect yourself in that, like, stick to those policies. You at one time have thought of them and you put it in your handbook for a reason. And so if a parent's not following a policy, this can be super hard, especially for most of us providers are great with kids, but we're somewhat introverts, and can be hard to kind of get that backbone to like be like, no, this is not my policy, and it's hard to do. But you have set that policy for a reason, and it's very important to stick to your policies, because nothing can burn you out faster than like one family taking advantage of a certain policy that you have set up, and you're letting that slide. My seventh tip is to, when you are interviewing, just remember that you are interviewing the family for yourself just as much as they are interviewing to see if you're a good fit. You want to see if they're a good fit. You don't have to enroll everybody. Like, even if the family is like ready to go and you have an open space, if they are not a good fit, don't enroll them into your program. The great thing about daycares is that there is so many, and every provider has a different personality, and it wouldn't be fair for you to take a child that you're going to struggle with, and or, you know, the family is just not a good fit for you. It's not fair for the child. It's not fair for you, because there's going to be another daycare out there that their personality fits best. Keep that in mind when you are interviewing. And this can be super hard at the beginning when you have, you know, you're first starting out and, you know, you have like four open spots and you're trying to fill those spots. Do not feel like you have to, you know, take the first four people that you interview. The great thing about daycare is for the parents, there's a lot of choices to choose from. And for you, for the provider, there is a lot of kids. My ninth tip is to stick to a schedule. I kind of touched on this when you're kind of setting goals for your kids, but have a schedule, and it can make your day go better. It can make your, you know, if you know, okay, we're going to have breakfast and then we're going to do circle time and then we're going to do some music time and then we're going to sit at the tables and have some learning activities. It can flow your day so much better than looking at a group of kids at 7 o'clock in the morning, knowing that they're not going to be picked up till 5 p.m. and thinking, what are we going to do? And so the schedule really helps me get through my day. You know, just on the weekends when I'm on Pinterest, or, you know, planning lessons and activities, just kind of fitting those activities into our schedule can just get you excited for your next week. And that can just really help with burnout. Okay, so my ninth trick is a little strange, and this is something that I started doing probably about 4 years into my daycare. And that is, every week I pull out a certain amount of money out of each of my kids' weekly tuition, and that is my like teacher appreciation money. Okay, so I look at that as kind of like my bonus money or my benefit money. Some people can call it like their egg money. At the end of the week, you pull out $5 from each kid. You're watching four kids, that's $20 a week that you get to use in ways that are just for you. So that could be you're getting money towards a pedicure. You could be just some chocolate that you hide by your desk. It could be like sometimes when I'm taking my daughter to therapy during the week, I'll swing through a drive-thru. And everybody is different of what they like. But I know it sounds weird, but for some reason this helps with my burnout. Just to know that I just have this little extra money that is just for me. And I like to keep the perspective of this is a little bit of a benefit to this job. So that's something that I have been doing for years. And, when I first started doing it, it might have been like a dollar a week from each kid. And I just worked up to so much. I even would recommend like raising your prices if financially there's just no money to pull out. Like raise your prices a couple dollars to kind of give you that little bit of teacher appreciation money. Okay, so then my last tip, the 10th tip, is to take time off. And at the beginning of every year, I like to look at the year and I like to kind of schedule out, my vacation time, my break times. I do take off most of the federal holidays. And I think that this is very important. It can be probably hard for the parents, but on the other side, I know that I am a better provider for taking time off. So I take time off around Christmas time, I take time off around Easter, I take vacation times, and then some federal holidays. And I make this very aware when I'm interviewing that I kind of show them my vacation time. But I think it is very important to take time off. No one can do daycare every day, 365 days a year. You will burn out way too quickly. Another red flag is sometimes when I see people like other providers posting that they have an opening and they'll say, they're open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And that, I would never enroll a child into a program that one person, one provider was open and providing care that many times. I'm not talking about like if you're, doing daycare with somebody else and, you do first shift and they do second shift, that's different. I'm talking about one provider providing care 24 hours a day. Like, I would be burned out within 2 days. Like, there's no way that you could do that. Like, and so I think this is probably my most important tip, is to take time off. All right, thanks for watching this video, guys. And I hope that some of these tips have helped you guys to kind of get some new ideas to help with that provider burnout. And I know that everyone has a different personality, so some of these will not pertain to you, but hopefully some of these do. And if you have any other things that you do to help with your provider burnout, please comment below and we'll just get a little conversation going. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you like this video. And I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.